Hi guys, welcome back to The Social Tune. And today, we're checking out the sequel to the rap trio Migos' album Culture, Culture 2.
Motorsport, yeah. Put that thing in sports. Shout it bad, pop it like a court. You a dork, never been a sport. Pull up, jumping out the court. Cotton candy, my cup tastes like the fair. Straight up there, where we didn't take the stairs.
So over the past couple of years, trap music has slowly been growing in popularity. Some could argue it started with Future, others will argue that it came into prominence thanks to websites like SoundCloud and Vine, but I think that a lot of that popularity can be traced back to Migos. The Atlanta trio, who have arguably had a bigger influence on rap music than any other act in the genre right now. That's right, even more influential than Kendrick or Drake. Now, does that make them better than those artists? No, obviously not. But to those of us who have been listening to hip-hop in the kind of underground for years now, seeing Bad and Bougie become such a huge smash hit last year was pretty surreal. This was the trio that trademarked the triplet flow that was suddenly everywhere. And although many don't like to talk about this, they had the hype and the personality to become absolutely huge. Which is key to understanding their appeal. These guys were always destined for the spotlight, and their breakthrough last year was long coming. With all of that said though, I've personally never been a huge fan of theirs. In terms of rap groups, Migos isn't anywhere close to others like Run the Jewels or Tribe Called Quest or Roots. But in more recent years, I've accepted that that's not what they're trying to be, so I should just accept their music for what it is. And it did help that Culture last year was pretty decent, so I was at least curious to see what they would deliver on Culture 2. And, well, in many ways, this is no different from a lot of their other albums. The real difference is, a lot of the best parts of those albums actually show up here a lot more often. Because yeah, against all odds, I did actually enjoy this quite a bit. So let's just get the most pointless part out of the way first, the lyrics and content.
Superstars, superstars, superstars out, hey. Brand new cars, yeah. We by the bar now, swaying doors now, fuck on hoes now, smash, shots and goals, cash, rock the shows, yeah. Big bang rolls, cash, now she go, for the team, now she wet, don't ski,
Okay, if you've heard a Migos album before, then you know what to expect here. Songs about money, drugs, cars, and about having sex with women, often your girl. It's what most people would call turn-up music, an album to play at parties. Although personally, I found a different use for it. I've recently been cycling everywhere, and let me tell you, this album has a great rhythm to it. Sure, the content is nowhere special, but it does still have some catchy hooks to it. And from time to time, they are a teeny tiny bit creative. Autopilot is all about how they don't have to try because they're just naturally gifted with a hook that is stupid, but also weirdly badass. Stir Fry is easily one of the most upbeat and fun songs that Migos have ever made, even if it is just a song about cooking and selling drugs. And I'll say it, Flooded actually did manage to impress me with an 8x8 rhyme scheme which shows some pretty competent writing. But my favorite song here is by far Too Much Jewelry, where they brag about having, well, you know, but the beat is easily the most beautiful or bejeweled one on the entire album, which was probably unintentional, but which I nevertheless did enjoy. Now, there are moments where it gets a little too stupid, like on Emoji a Chain, where they strive to make emojis themselves as valuable as a chain. That is the least gangsta thing that I've heard all year. Meanwhile, Made Men is all about how they made it because they're made for it, which, like I said before, is true. But the way they talk about how other less successful rappers didn't make it because they're not made for it just rubbed me the wrong way. It's just plain disrespectful to the culture you're supposed to be representing. Or on Beast, where this girl is described as a dick gobbler. Yeah, real classy, guys. Although maybe not quite as dismissive as Gang Gang, where they straight up tell their girls that they come second to the gang life, because, yeah, that certainly won't get you a slap in the face. But hey, lyrics are one thing, how about the guys delivering them?
Bitch, way better than his, bitch, yeah, we two player, we two player, yeah, we too player. We too player. Yeah, we too player. Yeah, we too player.
Now, in the past year, of these three, Offset is the one who has received the most praise for his lyrics and wordplay. And here, he's no exception, with a lot of pretty standout lines and flows. Next, you have Takeoff, who is pretty good and has some good moments, especially on 2 Playa, but is mostly about average. But of course, then we get to Quavo, who was utterly inescapable last year, and who the record labels clearly want to force down our throats even more here, as he's on every single song on this album, including handling several of the hooks. And to top it all off, he's clearly not trying, with a laid-back and lazy delivery and a voice that is usually drowning in autotune. And furthermore, having all three of these guys rap on pretty much every single song here has a disappointing and predictable result, namely that the album runs extremely long, 1 hour and 46 minutes to be exact. And yeah, no matter how good your beats are, after a while that gets really tedious, especially considering the artists involved aren't all that interesting, and the fact that every single song here runs a little too long. As usual, Drake sounds half asleep on Walk It, Talk It, which was already dull thanks to that stilted and repetitive chorus. Lucky for him, 21 Savage shows up on Bad Bitches Only and takes the cake for the most boring performer on this album. Next you have Post Malone, who is perfectly detestable on Notice Me, and don't even get me started on Travis Scott, Ty Dolla Sign, and Big Sean on White Sand. They were all terrible. But otherwise, it's a mixed bag, but mostly positive. Gucci Mane is perfectly disposable on his track. Luckily, 2 Chainz then comes in to give some real energy to 2 Playa, as does Cardi B on Motorsport. She really has grown on me. Although the real star on that track was Nicki Minaj, who hasn't sounded this good on a song in ages, with some really savage bars. So okay, the good performances kind of balance out the bad ones, so how are the beats? Okay, so like I said, Migos is made for a certain type of environment, so going into this, I wasn't expecting much. Some dumb moments here and there, maybe, but mostly interchangeable content and good beats to vibe out to. And with that in mind, the instrumentation and the hooks actually got me through this album fairly easily. Like I said before, if you have this on during a commute or an exercise period, this is the perfect background music, as it has a very steady tempo with some beautiful standout moments. From the blast of surprisingly tasteful autotune towards the end of Too Much Jewelry, which almost sounded like an 808s and Heartbreaks moment of transcendence, to the pianos all across this album with their distinct and soothing melodies, to the surprisingly gorgeous saxophone on 2 Playa, to the strings and bells on the opener. Even on the terrible songs like Notice Me and White Sand, the production is good enough to make you believe that the sun may shine again. Even if, again, they are both bad songs. But that's kind of the thing about this album. Its length is both a blessing and a curse. It is far too long, and there's a reason that it has faced so much backlash. But because of the length of it, there's more room to actually drop good quality, which they actually do. You still get some bad songs, but even they have redeeming qualities, and you're honestly not gonna remember them because they're not the songs you're going to be returning to. So yeah, ultimately, I did enjoy this album more than I expected. I realized that I am kind of doing this in the wrong order. I mean, I started out hating Migos, then found them inoffensive, and now I like them. While most people didn't care about them, liked them when they first broke through, and now all seem to hate them. And look, I get why. It's 106 minutes long, for God's sake. But for me, it's still an extremely light 6 out of 10. And while I know it's interchangeable, and many people will probably crack after the first 7 songs, there are ultimately more good elements here and fewer bad ones than on any of their other albums. So yeah, probably a controversial opinion, but hopefully we can agree to disagree and you can still leave a like if you enjoyed this. Otherwise, if there are any other albums you'd like me to check out, then please post them in the comments or tweet them at me at the Social Tune. link in the description. In the meantime, please subscribe so you don't miss a thing, and until the next time, I'm Finn, and this is The Social Tunes, signing off.